This video is all about bounce rate. What is bounce rate? What is bounce rate in Google Analytics? What's the formula for calculating bounce rate so that you can do it on your own? What's a good bounce rate? What's a bad bounce rate? What does 100 bounce rate mean? We'll talk about that as well. I'll give you tips on reducing the bounce rate, as well as finally talk about bounce rate in Google Analytics 4. But before we dive into the video, make sure to subscribe to this channel, hit the bell icon so that you never miss any new videos from me, as well as give this video a thumbs up. So if you're ready, let's dive in. I'm going to show you an example to demonstrate what bounce rate is. Let's say I go to Google and I type in Optizint Academy. And then I click on this link, go to Optizint Academy, and then without clicking on any link or taking any action or viewing any other page, I just go back to the search engine. In that case, I have bounced from the site. I don't have to necessarily go back to the search engine. I could have simply left the site by closing the browser or typing in a different URL. When a user arrives to your site and leaves without taking any further action, by default, further action is a new page view. That's considered a bounce. Bounce rate is measured at a page level or at the site level and expressed as percentage. For a page, bounce rate equals to bounces on that page, which means people who came via that page and left without going any further, divided by the total entrance on that page, which means number of total visits that entered the site via that page. That means that was the first page they encountered. Multiplied by 100 to get the percentage. For a site, bounce rate equals to bounces across the site. You look at all the entrances on all the pages and see how many of them bounced, and then divide by total visits to the site.
And then multiply that ratio with 100 to get the percentage.
Keep in mind, bounce rate is time specific. So it could be a day, month, year, whatever time frame you're doing your analysis for. Let me explain this concept of page bounce rate using this picture. The page in question is this landing page. There are 16 visits that enter your site through this landing page. Out of those 16, 4 immediately leave without going any further. However, other 4 go to another page on your site and 8 go to yet another page. So what you have here is 16 entrances. So you have total visits entering from the page on your site is 16. Visits that leave without going any further is 4. So your bounce rate is 4 divided by 16. That is equal to 25%. That's at the page level bounce rate. Now let's look at the site level bounce rate. Let's take an example of your website where you have 3 pages. One is your landing page. You could consider this as a home page, or it could be any other landing page, and you have another page and yet another page. So total 3 pages. Let's assume you got 16 people that come via this landing page. So they are entering the site through this landing page. 8 of them go and continue to another page. 4 of them go to this page, and rest 4 leave the site from this landing page. So they come and they leave. So we looked at this scenario where 4 of them left and 12 of them stayed, and the bounce rate was 4 divided by 16. However, that was the case for a landing page bounce rate. In this example, we are looking at site level bounce rate. In order to do that, we have to look at all the entrances to this site from various pages. So we've looked at one page here, you've got 16 entrances. Now let's assume you have 8 entrances from the top page here.
So you have 16 sessions starting from the home page and 8 starting from another page. So that's total of 24 visits on the site.
Of these 8 people, 4 immediately leave from the page, 4 continue to another page. People are entering the site from various pages and are either leaving the site immediately or continuing to other pages. These 4 people then decide to go to the main landing page. These 4 people decide to leave from the top page. So now you have to calculate the bounce rate. Remember, bounce rate is total number of bounces divided by total number of visits to the site. So how many total visits to the site we have? We have 16 people who came and then they're going through the site or leaving. And then you have 8 people who are coming to the site and then either continuing or leaving. So total visits to the site are 16 plus 8, 24. That's your total visits. How many bounces are we getting? We look at the bounces from all the pages. In this scenario, we got 4 bounces. In this scenario, we got 4 bounces. Rest of the people are just going through the site. These people are not counted as bounces because they continued to another page on the site and then decided to leave. These are called exits, not bounces. Bounces is people who come and leave immediately. Who come and leave immediately without going any further. So total bounces are visits with one page view. These are the bounces. So your bounce rate in this case is going to be 8 divided by 24, that is 33%. Another version of bounce rate is very specific to emails and it's called email bounce rate. The definition of email bounce rate is different from the definition of web page or website bounce rate.
I will cover email bounce rate in another video if there is enough interest. If you're interested to know more about email bounce rate, then leave me a comment and I will create a new video for you. The focus of this video is to discuss the bounce rate on landing pages and websites. Now that you understand what bounce rate is and how it's calculated, let's go to Google Analytics and see where you can see bounce rate in Google Analytics. In Google Analytics, this is Universal Analytics, not Google Analytics 4, also called GA3, you will find bounce rate in most of the reports. So here I'm in Behavior Overview, and this is the site bounce rate. To look at the bounce rate for each individual page, you can go to either all pages or landing pages. I'm going to go ahead and click on landing pages. And this is where you can see the bounce rate for each and every page. Now that you understand what's a bounce rate, how it's calculated, where to find in Google Analytics, the next question is, what's a good or a bad bounce rate? 30% is a great bounce rate. That's what you will expect from a very well-designed site. Anything under 50% is good. However, if you get above 50%, then there is a problem on the site or the landing pages. Bounce rate of 100 indicates that there is a big problem on your site or landing page. That means every user who's coming to your site is leaving immediately. While your goal should be to lower the bounce rate, anything lower than 10% indicates a problem with the tracking on your site. A bounce rate of lower than 10% indicates that you have put double tracking on your web pages. The impact of double tracking is that when a user lands on a web page or your site, immediately you're sending 2 hits to Google Analytics, which tells Google Analytics that it's not a bounce. Bounce means only single hit or a single page view. If your whole site is double tagged, then you will see 0% bounce rate. So pay attention to that and make sure to audit your Google Analytics tracking. If you're interested to know how to audit your Google Analytics tracking, then check out the link in the description of this video. Bounce rate is also impacted by the type of the site or the page. Blogs generally have 50 to 70% bounce rate because generally people come to read a blog post and then leave. Contact us pages also have 50 plus percent bounce rate. They might even be closer to 70 to 100%. Homepage of a site should have lower bounce rate, 30% or less. So pay attention to the type of page, evaluate every page and see what are you expecting users to do. That's how you can evaluate whether you are getting the right bounce rate or not. Now let's talk about why users bounce and what can you do to improve your bounce rate. First one is wrong clicks. This generally happens when users accidentally click on your links in search engines, ads, emails, etc. In that case, when users realize that they are in the wrong place, they will immediately go back. That means they'll bounce. There's not much you can do about it. It happens. That's why you'll never get to 100% because you will get some users who have accidentally arrived on your site. Mismatched expectations is another one. This is a big one. This generally happens when there is a mismatch between the source where the user came from and where the user landed. For example, if you are promoting an offer in your ad, Let's say you're saying 50% off. When a user arrives on your landing page or your site and does not see that 50% off banner or call to action or wordings on your site, that's mismatched expectations. This is something you control. Make sure all your links, all your ads, all your emails are pointing to the right landing pages with the right experience. If not, then you will find a very high bounce rate on those landing pages. Another reason for bounces is slow loading pages. If your website loads very slowly, users will lose patience and they will generally bounce back. If you're seeing a very high bounce rate across your site or on certain pages that you know should not have very high bounce rate, then look at the page loading speed. An experiment by Microsoft showed that improving the page speed by even few microseconds can lead to higher engagement and conversions. So pay attention to the page loading speed. And finally, a reason contributing to high bounce rate is users' expectations again. In this case, rather than mismatch expectations, their expectations are met. For example, if I'm searching for a phone number for a local bank, I'm likely going to go to Google or Bing and search for it. The result set is likely to contain their contact us page with the phone information. In that case, I'm going to go to the site, grab the phone number, and bounce. This is called good bounce rate because you are expecting the users to find that information on that page. You should not be worried about such bounce rate. It's a good bounce rate. Can you further improve it? Sure. You can try to put more information on that page that can drive users further. However, if the user only went there for the phone number, they got what they were looking for. I won't worry too much about those pages till you improve the other parts of the business. So now let's talk about bounce rate in Google Analytics 4 or GA4. As you might have already noticed, there is no bounce rate in GA4. What you have instead is engagement. So here, when you go to acquisition, traffic acquisition, or user acquisition, you'll see engaged sessions, engagement time per session, etc. If you step back and think about what was bounce rate measuring, bounce rate was measuring the lack of engagement, which means it's the opposite of engagement, right? People who did not engage with your site immediately left were counted as bounces. However, engagement metrics that Google Analytics 4 has created is not directly opposite of bounces. It involves more than just bounces. Engaged sessions are calculated by looking at all the sessions that spent more than 10 seconds on the site or had a conversion event or did not bounce. So it's taking all of those to find engaged sessions. I will talk about GA4 engagement in another video. Go ahead and comment below if you would like me to create that video. So that's it. That's all about bounce rates. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and hit the bell icon so that you never miss any new videos from me. Go ahead and comment below and let me know what you think about this video, and I will see you in the next video.